Okay, take a seat. We're gonna have a talk that I probably should have given you a long time ago. Today we're going to talk about what units are worth keeping early on in Summoner's War. This is a topic that I see a lot on our forums, so I figured I'd compile our answers in a top 10 list. So here we go, number 10, Darien. Darien's damage reduction effect is really useful for helping to break into GB10. In fact, he even got an honorable mention in the starter GB10 team video. That same effect can also provide some added stability for your raids team later on. Number 9, Lauren. She's a multi-hitter that can help you form an NB10 team, and for more info on that, I recommend that you scope out our starting free-to-play NB10 guide. She's also part of the fusion for Jean, so in a weird indirect sort of way, she can help with RTA. Number 8, Mav, the actual unironic king of TOA. Provoke, stun, heal, cooldown reduction, he has it all. Number 7 is Lulu, or Baby Velajoule as I like to call her. She's an accessible and suspiciously viable source of cleanse and immunity. She's available through Unknown Scrolls and the Magic Shop. Number 6 is Spectra. Spectra is another huge help in TOA. You'll notice a lot of those on this list because the rewards are really helpful, especially when starting out. He has high damage potential and the highest base speed in the game at 126. Plus, he has an AoE attack bar reduction and slow on the third skill. Number 5 is Megan the Water Mystic Witch. Megan is an attack bar booster with a couple of useful and flexible buffs. That combined with her second skill, which has a chance to strip beneficial effects off a single target, make her ideal for Giants and Dragons B10. For more info on that, and I know I keep saying it, you should really scope out our starter free-to-play guides for Giants and Dragons. She appears on both. Number 4. Colleen is still nuts, dude. This is the third time I've said it, and it probably won't be the last. She has a spotlight on the channel as a PvE Titan, and she's featured in our starter free-to-play NB10 guide, and I've recommended her for raids. She's available through the Magic Shop and has a skill set that's filled to the brim with utility. Number 3, Konamiya is the Garuda that keeps on giving. He has a weirdly reliable stun on his first skill, a cleave facilitator on the second skill, and a full team heal and cleanse on the third. Kona's helpful in Arena, Raids, TOA, and ultimately more places than I have time to list here. Number 2 is Bernard. There's a lot of weirdly bird-like monsters in the latter half of this list. He's an attack bar booster that you can get just by clearing the third floor of Giants under the Giants Keepmaster Challenge quest. Bernard is great for making sure your damage dealers get a turn with a 30% attack bar boost and a speed buff. Plus, he has a wind attack bonus leader skill. I wonder who that benefits. Alright. Number 1, who are we even kidding? It's Bella Dion. Now, this good dog's a little different because instead of just keeping Bella, you should actively seek him out. Bella Dion can be used everywhere. I won't go into as much detail as I'd like because we already have a monster spotlight on the channel, but there's a reason why the Light Inugami is at the top slot of our list. Bella Dion has a super synergistic kit with defense break on the first skill, strip on the second, a heal and attack bar boost on the third, plus it's a unit that will grow with you. Bella Dion is going to be relevant across all contents in the game. And before I go, I just want to emphasize that this is our personal list, but what does yours look like? Leave it in a comment so I can compare. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day, everyone. Bye-bye.